So always in our strategic plan, always something that we're always talking about in public health. The next one is over on the last page, and this is social and economic factors. And you know, in public health, we always look at the whole person. We're not just looking at those chronic factors or what you go to the doctor for, or the smoking and those types. But we look at the whole person and what may affect their health. In that category under social and economic factors, one of the things that concerns me a little bit is the low percent of some college. We look at that. And I'm not even looking at four-year degrees and those types of things, but you know, one of the things we've talked about in the community for some time is pushing any type of college that will get you, whether it's a two-year degree to do electricians or plumbing or any type of things like that, all the way up through a four-year degree, to make sure that people have that type of training when they go out into the workforce. So just a little bit low on that one thing that we might want to look at. Children in poverty was a little bit high, with 22% for 18% in North Carolina. I did flag that as well.
So we're very prohibiting income inequality, right?
I think it's pretty, I didn't mark that one, so I felt pretty good about that. I think, you know, when you're looking at income across the state or income across the nation comparatively, I think 3.7 to 4.7 is not that far off. I would be interested to see how that was broken down and which categories